This week, our team of bonsai builders take on a high-octane challenge. Transform this modest bungalow into a racing fan's dream palace. These homeowners have agreed to hand over the keys to our master of monster makeovers, Steve Watson. An average Joe with a passion for bigger, badder, and bolder, Steve is on a mission to shift home remodeling into overdrive.
What do you think you're gonna have when we're finished?
I don't know, but I'm very scared.
Our house was plain and simple. It was safe and normal. It was nice and sweet. But we all agreed we could use a change. And then something happened that was very strange. Cause a van showed up, all our stuff went flying. And my mom was crying till the job was done. Now it's a monster house. It's a monster house. It's a monster house. And we all just love it. It's a monster house.
Santiago and Kara Lopez are a suburban couple with two kids, a mortgage, and a serious need for speed.
You're in a car going as fast as you can. Oh, it's so much fun.
We're going racing!
Most Saturdays, you can find them and their souped-up imports at the local drag strip for some family fun on the quarter mile.
We take the kids with us. The kids have just as much of a blast as we do. And I just love it because it's a family event.
They have agreed to let Steve and his crew transform their single-story ranch house into a race car retreat. The catch? The design and construction will be left entirely in the hands of Steve and his team of monster builders. All the Lopezes will know is what they can see from a motorhome parked out front. But first, our team needs a game plan. Steve brainstorms a blueprint for the Lopez family's race car retreat with his monster house designers. Architect Todd Erlinson, illustrator Craig Rizzo, and this week's guest designer, drag racer Ron Capps.
All right, guys. The Lopez family, the ultimate racing fans. We have to give them the ultimate racing fan house. Well, let's take a look at this thing.
It's kind of really simple, type 5 construction house, slab on grade, 2x4 construction, aluminum windows. You guys shouldn't have too much trouble doing just about anything they wanted.
Let's start in the kitchen. I stand in the kitchen, and I want to feel like I'm in a garage.
Like a gas station. You go to a gas station where they change your oil, and you know they got those air hoses that come down.
Maybe these things come down, and they can be apparatuses for doing your daily chores in the kitchen.
What's this island about? What's it going to look like?
Well, you got to start with a toolbox, a flashy red toolbox.
It's all industrial parts. You have diamond plate countertops,
gas-fired barbecue that could happen inside.
Lots of flames.
Yeah, lots of flames would be good.
Got a headers or use a fan or something to get the air out.
Yeah, you gotta have some headers.
I mean, you go back to the 50s, that was the first thing a guy put on was a carburetor and a set of headers.
Mm-hmm. The dining room. There's something in the dining room has to scream cars, has to scream racing.
Could you literally pull the car right into the house?
I'd love to have cars in the house.
It's extreme, but that's what the show's about. Let's put a car in there. You start with the table itself. You gotta make something out of the table. Let's say a hood or something that would come out of the wall.
All right, how about the kids' room? The kids' room, we've got to take care of the kids. I'm thinking the trunk of a car. If you're going to have the front end of a car here, then why not just have the back end of a car there? You know, just put a hatchback in there with some seats, man. That's where they sit and they play the PlayStation. That's where they rock out.
How can you get the piece of the car in there?
Not my problem. I just want it there. How about the master
bedroom? Any idea?
Got to do something in the master bedroom.
Make the bed into a car. Make it a car.
How do you make something that doesn't move fast?
They've been married a while, right?
Yeah.
So you know when you get married a while, things kind of calm down a bit. So you get a little bit, things going a little bit.
Spice up a little bit. Like airbags.
Bed's got to move like a cheap hotel.
Yeah, make it a 5-speed turbocharged king-size bed. Nice.
The monster master plan looks like this. The kitchen counter will be converted into a toolbox range. The dining room table will be replaced by a drop-top car hood. The kids' room will feature a car trunk sofa. For the master bedroom, an airbag suspension for the California King. Dragster Ron Capps comes up with the perfect finishing touch.
I want a motorized easy chair.
He's talking a recliner that does 0 to 30 in under 5 seconds.
30 mile per hour easy chair. I mean, that's what we all want, right? Let's see him pull that off.
All right, guys, I like it. I Hope they like it.
Now it's time to turn this speed demon facelift over to our monster construction crew. It's first thing Monday morning. The Lopez family heads for the motorhome. On the horizon, five men with a mission, five men with a sledgehammer. The challenge: complete this entire remodel in only 5 days. The prize, for each of them, a tool package worth over $3,000. This week's crew: Michael Reagan, Hollywood production designer. Kurt Myers, robot builder. Travis Kenny, street rod customizer. Danny Snell, master electrician. And Lester O'Malley, general contractor.
Okay, guys, here you go.
All right, let's tear it up.
Take care of my house.
Did he say tear it up?
Item one on their to-do list, a keyless entry.
Gentlemen, good morning.
Let's get to work.
Foreman Steve rolls out his plan.
All right, here's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna build the ultimate race fans home. That's your job in 5 days. This, gone. We're gonna replace this island with a toolbox. Diamond plated top, work lights, exhaust system, two burners, indoor grill, and these are all gonna be operational tools. And it gets better. You have to build these bar stools.
How many?
Two. This wall, this is the front grill of a car. Good. This folds down, that's your dining room table.
We're gonna get the kids a really cool room in here.
The back side of the car, that is the dining room table. You're gonna take the trunk out, put in two seats. His sons can sit, play their PlayStation, watch movies. This is their playroom.
Excellent.
It's the master bedroom. Ready for this? This is the new master bed. It's gonna be on airbags.
Oh, yeah.
We all like getting thrown out the bed every now and then. I have no problem with that.
And finally, something no race car house should be without.
Here it is, a racing recliner. And they can race up and down the street. You guys have a lot of work to do this week. It's your job to get it done. It's your challenge. You guys can do it?
Oh, yeah.
Can you get it done in 5 days?
Oh, yeah.
It's a lot of work.
We're ready for it.
Good. Let's move on to it.
Let's get to work.
The crew starts off with a quick huddle in order to slice this hot rod pie into bite-sized pieces.
Here, the layout and the planning is going to be the most crucial.
Yeah, while we work in teams, we can split up. There's enough of us to.
Normally, you do all your demo first that you're going to do.
Yeah.
So, demo here.
Demo.
Well, this all has to go out. Is there any liability here for us?
Before stepping on the accelerator,
moving day,
they wisely decide to move out anything that might break. Then it's time for the demolition derby.
Nice work, Lester.
By mid-morning, the delivery trucks start to arrive. First up, two rockin' red mechanics tool chests that will become the base for the kitchen island.
Put pins in the floor, ram set pins in the floor, and we're gonna bowl them down to the floor so it won't go anywhere. But we gotta take it apart first. That's the fun part.
Electric stuff.
A cab load of cartons from Davis Wholesale Electric Supply. And what every construction site needs, a sizable stack of sheetrock and wood, courtesy of Stock Building Supply.
What happened to gravity? I was careful with my wood.
Now that they've got some toys to play with, the crew is getting excited.
We're psyched, we're on fire, we're jammed, we're ready to go.
I always finish on time.
It'd be cool to have
to find the many car parts they'll need to build the racing designs. They plan a shopping trip to the local scrapyard. Number one on the list, the back end of a car that will become the kids' playroom sofa.
What about height?
53's right here.
We figured 52.
52 would be good if we can get a desk.
Then even if it was a full swing,
On the hatchback.
52. Start calling wrecking yards or go to wrecking yards or something.
A few quick calls and Travis finds a local junkyard that has everything they need.
He's got cars that are like half wrecked that we can use the whole car. He's gonna cut the front half and the back half.
Kurt and Travis head off on the mission.
We're gonna head off to a wrecking yard and dial in this rear half of the car and the front half of the car, hopefully all at the same kill.
I think our biggest challenge is to get the chop shop to start cutting up the car we want.
Yeah.
So everything's doable.
Everything's doable.
Will we get it done in 5 days? This will find out.
I want the back end of something like that. I want the front end of any type of Honda.
See, we need like to mount this to a wall, and we have to have the hatch so it can open up.
I like that back end.
And then we're gonna have like a couch, like seat inside there.
I need a flush cut right through here.
We need like the grill, the bumper.
It's gonna be coming through a wall basically.
Scrounging through tons of twisted metal, they discover buried treasure, a Del Sol with a nice rear end.
Yeah, I'm digging this thing. What kind of deal can you make me on this half with a hatch? Nobody wants this stuff, huh?
So you do.
What do you say, boss?
I could do about 800. Rent.
Back at the house, Lester fine-tunes the tool chests.
This is called the large adjustment tool.
He bolts the boxes together to build a solid base for the kitchen island. Then he checks his work.
Function test. It meets Monster House standards.
The island will be topped off with an industrial strength gas grill.
You could make one hell of a steak dinner with this grill. Now I want this kitchen in my house.
Back at the junkyard, Travis and Kurt have made it to the checkout line.
Now, believe it or not, this hood, I can let you have it dirt cheap because it's not perfect.
Headlights are how much?
$75, brand new, shiny.
Both of them?
Each.
Oh man, you're killing me here.
Like 60 bucks. About 100 bucks. I can have everything tomorrow.
We got 1350, boss.
It's closing in on dusk by the time they return with a box full of parts and a pocket full of promises from the junk man.
What kind of car you get? Got a Del Sol, got all the wheels, got some 17.
He's ordering.
What, so you got the wheels and stuff?
1400.
That's not bad.
Everything delivered.
It's not bad.
It's not bad at all. It's all the car stuff.
Outside, Kara Lopez comes home to discover it's raining on her kitchen.
Oh, brother. My kitchen's in the front lawn. I'm gonna cry. It was mom.
She wants to see what's going on inside, but Steve reminds her of the rules.
You wanna go inside, take a sneak peek?
Sure, let's go.
No.
No peeking.
You're gonna love it. I'm gonna go back inside and see what we're tearing out right now.
I'll follow you.
I'll see you later on.
All righty. And the nerves are definitely going now. It wasn't so bad during the day. Now I come home and see the kitchen in the lawn. I didn't expect what I got.
She has no idea.
Oh, we're going. Yeah, here we go.
By 8 p.m., the crew has done what they can in the kitchen. Without car parts to work with, they decide to leave the other rooms for tomorrow and call it a night. Tuesday morning, the Lopez's wake up from a nervous night in the motorhome.
I really can't worry about what they're going to do because I have no idea what they're going to do. So we'll just have to wait and see.
As Kara heads off to work, the crew shows up with a full head of steam.
It's going
to
come together. We're gonna pound today.
Last night, Lester came up with an inspired idea for amping up the existing ceiling fans.
We're just gonna run a fan above the stove. It's gonna come on way over here to the corner, and it's gonna run over to the living room and run our ceiling fan in the living room.
In short, turn them into ceiling radiators, all connected by a moving fan belt.
And put some, you know, stainless steel or some chromed blades on there or some flames on them. I mean, whatever we had time to do.
A little smooth talking, and this silver tongue contractor is able to get a real deal from fan maker Fanimation.
Gave him a buzz. I say, hey, what do I need to do to get these gratis? The gentleman was very helpful with me. Just, hey, let me know what you need and go from there.
They've agreed to supply our monster house with $10,000 worth of fans for a total price of...
Zero, except for shipping.
Danny arrives with his own charitable contributions.
This came out of my garage up in the attic at about 5 o'clock this morning. Some custom headers I had made for a car I was building and never got used, and There you go, $400 headers.
Headers and gaugers and motors, oh my.
But with one day down and not much done, Steve is starting to feel the pressure.
We're behind. And the problem is, you know, not only that if they lose, then I lose. I have to talk to the family, and I have to take the family in on Saturday and show them a half-finished house. And I'm just not willing to do that.
In the kitchen, our electrician Danny takes on the job of framing the top for the tool chest counter.
Call a professional by the proper misuse of tools.
This is an electrician's hammer.
There you go.
That's monster house stuff. We gotta hang diamond plate on it, and we need some kind of strong backing for the diamond plate to hang on. This all has a really good area to screw to.
Meanwhile, Mike tries his hand at wiring. Danny finishes his frame out.
This is gonna be perfect.
Not bad for a wire jockey. To give the counters that racing garage finish, Steve's ordered steel diamond plate.
And don't try this at home.
Travis makes cardboard templates to help turn these sheets of steel into high-tech trim.
You're buying that?
I like it.
Yeah, it's special. I think I'm gonna take this one all the way to the top so that the diamond plate doesn't roll this side, just rolls that side.
Okay.
Diamond plate here just to kind of clean everything up. And then the whole top will be diamond plate. It'll break on this side. Most of our diamond plate templates are pretty much dialed in now.
The thick diamond plate will have to be cut at a nearby metal shop.
Okay, man. Thanks. Okay. I'm gonna take all the templates and stuff with the diamond plate and just go drop them off. And he said he could probably have them done, sheared, cut, and ready for us tomorrow afternoon.
Back in the kitchen, Danny the electrician finally notices that Mike is treading on his turf.
Go do it. I didn't tell you. You jumped in. I said you were all worried about it. This is what I'm doing. So you don't worry about it.
Do you know how to frame this stuff? Why don't you come frame and let me do my job? How about
that? You want to do the electrics?
That's what I'm here
for. I could do framing or electrics. Don't matter to me.
They're arguing about electrical. One guy believes in the ground, one guy doesn't.
They both want everything to be to code, want everything done right. Both want to get to the same point. Of course, you can't have too many roosters in the hen house, plain and simple.
Everything okay? We're cool. Danny just gets excited every so often. That's what it's all about, I guess. Since I am an electrician by trade, I figured it'd probably be better and quicker if I get to work on that. Then we know it's done right.
We're still not really getting a whole lot done except for just a lot of bitching.
Travis has had enough.
So I'm gonna blaze out of here and get my done.
He loads up his templates and diamond plate and rolls off to the metal shop.
That's it. I kind of got stuck doing a lot of the templates and crap in the kitchen, which really wasn't my gig, but I was waiting on steel, so I didn't have anything else better to do. You cut that out, no problem. Pretty simple.
The metal man says the cutout should be done by morning. Stripped of his electrical duties, Mike takes a crack at the kitchen ceiling.
We're gonna be putting a new exhaust system in for this fancy kitchen stove here.
Back from the metal shop, Travis teams up with Danny to fabricate a turbocharged bed frame.
I'm gonna do cutting some metal for the bed, start making the frame so we can start getting something done on it. Here we go.
We're 113 right now.
Steve shows up with more toys.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
The airbag suspension parts for turning this bed into a bouncing street rod.
We're going high tech here. Excess air pressure, some shock waves. They're actually adjustable. Up and down we go.
Out front, the junk man cometh with a flatbed full of scavenged metal.
Yes, he did. All right.
One man's trash is another man's treasure.
That was a good idea. What?
Four steel wheels to brace up the bed, and two more for the bar stool seats, and an aftermarket dining room table ensemble.
Front bumper for the dining room.
But the prize jewel is a freshly cut rump off a Honda Del Sol. The trick now is going to be getting it into the kids' room.
Okay, coming through. Watch out. All right.
Talking about the dirt on the end here.
Watch it for that truck.
The boys wrestled their prize into the backyard.
Park the car in the yard.
To turn it into a sofa, Travis trims off some excess fat. But Steve sees a problem.
I don't think this thing's necessary. I think this thing gets in the way.
That was the whole idea. You guys talked about a hatch and a pitcher.
I just changed it. Screw it. Get rid of it.
Need more headroom? Nix the trunk lid. Ditching the trunk lid turns out to be a blessing in disguise. Danny realizes that the hinges will be perfect for hanging the car hood table to the wall.
That goes on the wall.
That's exactly. Up and...
You got it, baby. That's what, and it mounts right to that hood.
Good job.
But they still need to squeeze the Del Sol into the kids' room. To do that, they'll need every inch of clearance they can get.
I got it. Don't bend it too much. I got it down
don't
here.
Don't pull out on it like this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got help over there. It's just set right there.
Yeah, watch out. We got to put it in. You guys have to push even higher.
Okay, now you guys have to push high.
There you go,
it's
only a test.
Oh, hard,
there's
only
two
of
us.
We got it here still.
Going down.
Okay. Yes. That's gonna be one hell of a couch.
Layout's on one side, so.
Nice.
That gentleman is how you put a car in a house.
Just after sundown, the cut pieces of diamond plate show up a day early. So far, it's the only thing that's ahead of schedule. The crew can't resist setting the pieces of gleaming steel into place.
Just gorgeous.
I think this is bad.
Big monster.
This is.
But it's getting late, and they decide to call it a night.
Good job.
Outside, Kara Lopez is still wondering what she's gotten herself into.
Hoping everything's going good. Inside, no one will let me know anything, so I really can't get too excited because I have no idea what's going on.
Saturday.
Three more days.
It's Wednesday.
Good morning.
2 days down, three to go.
Tonight's gonna be your long night for sure.
Ready for it. Here we go.
Lester grabs a cup of Joe and faces his first major decision of the day. Glazed or cream-filled?
I put my hand on every single one of them. Now they're all mine.
The big guy grabs one for the road, then heads off to pick up his ceiling fans. In the kitchen, Kurt and Travis realize they can't attach the diamond plate until Lester bolts the tool chest to the floor.
All I want to do, so we can finish this today, which I've asked him three times, just get this thing bolted down, and this part would be done.
Take control of it and tell him that's what you need and just start doing it.
Exactly.
Yeah. This has got to be finished before we go to lunch. I want this thing done.
I agree.
Finish the hood.
So Travis moves on to the bar stools.
Weld some bolts on there. Bolt it down, stick it on the base, and be done with it.
To attach the wheel rims to the pedestals, he welds bolts to the bracket. Outside, Mike once again is treading on Danny the electrician's turf. He adds a circuit breaker to handle the additional power needed for all these monster modifications.
We had a problem with the power going into the garage because a lot of things are being powered from there. We have the compressor, everything in the bedroom, and all of the garage is on one circuit in there. So it won't fry the wire, but it'll kick the breaker and it won't sustain for more than a few minutes.
Then he climbs up into the attic to drop the new wiring down through the walls.
I'm running the line up there and I'm pulling it through. Can you go in the corner and just wiggle that wire so I can see how much you got left?
In the backyard, Kurt has started turning the Lopez's lounge chair into the motorized racing recliner. So far, all he's got is a steel frame, onto which he'll need to mount wheels, motors, batteries, belts, and assorted gizmos.
Let's see.
Beyond that, the plan is a little sketchy.
I'm making a plate that this motor can bolt to.
On the back patio, the pit crew screws on a few lug nuts and rolls out a fine set of bar stools.
That's kind of nice.
It's not the best tip. But
what do you think? That's perfect. Every house needs one of these.
It's almost halfway through the week, and the first monster masterpiece crosses the finish line. Still in high gear, Travis and Danny start fabricating a brace for mounting the front end of a 95 Accord to the dining room wall.
Thank you.
table when it's up should be right here. Tabletop is...
Next, they attach the car hood that will serve as a drop-down table.
We're well underway.
They start to bolt the hinges scavenged from the Del Sol's trunk onto the hood.
Yeah. Okay.
But there's a problem. Steve's just found a flaw in his design.
Forget about the design there, but we decided we would turn the hood backwards and have it come down and they can eat on a flat surface.
A sloped hood isn't exactly the ideal surface for holding a hot plate of food, so Steve turns the design upside down.
It has to look cool and it has to function.
Even if you had to put your support, the support or whatever, this is more functional as far as design.
I couldn't see eating on the hood of a car like this.
God, no.
Flipping the hood flattens the table, but it raises a red flag for Travis and Danny. The hinges now need to swing the other way.
Since originally this is gonna be easy because we could have just used stock hinges and everything would have folded up and down just perfect, exactly like a car hood. Now we're gonna have to fab something to so we have different style hinges completely. Trial and error, we'll get it. Sooner or later we'll get it.
Plan A is out the window and plan B is nowhere in sight.
All right. Guys, I think the fans are here.
It's nearly noon, and Lester has just returned with 10 grand worth of ceiling fans. High ticket? Yes. Monster house? Uh-uh.
That's the most gaudy thing I've ever seen in my life. No way.
Steve's fit hits the fan.
Does this go into a race car house?
I don't think so.
Thank you very much. No, absolutely not. Look at that. We can't put that in this house.
It's monster vision versus builder reality, and the team is talking mutiny.
Isn't it up to us? Because we're the ones who have to make the homeowners happy.
No, we're not going from radiator fan blades.
Can we modify
to
these?
This?
Can we modify them and use the parts then?
We make this a hubcap.
If you make it look cool, I'll let you use it. Right now, that's not going up on the ceiling.
But that's a lot of extra work, and I don't know when we're going to do it.
You guys are killing me.
Well, there's 10 grand worth of stuff here. This is a monster. I don't know what the hell it is.
Look at this.
They're smoking crack if they don't think it is.
You got your crack pipe out? It was a radiator fan.
Lester busted his to get these fans for free from this company, Fanimation, and they're beautiful. They're beautiful for any home. I would love to have them in my home. This is a race car fantasy monster house. We asked for radiator type fans with stainless steel on a belt drive motor, and what we got was something that you would see at Morton's Steakhouse.
He's the host. We're the guys doing the work.
Yeah.
We're the ones who have everything hinging on this. It's up to us, not up to him.
Ugh. I just feel like breaking it.
It's a major strikeout for the monster team, and Travis is starting to feel a little like Barry Bonds.
I don't care about the fan. I don't care about the fan. I don't care about the fan.
Today is a good day.
Tuning out the turmoil, Travis and Danny have figured out how to hang their flip-flop drop-top table. They fabricated a hinge out of scrap metal.
That's going to weld on to the hood. This bar is going to act as our hinge. And so it'll hinge up, hinge down, take out some sheetrock, bolt it in. We're done hanging it. Done deal.
New and improved method of doing this. Sweet.
Big dog Lester retreats to the kitchen to blow off steam. And finally finished bolting the tool chest to the floor.
I wouldn't stand there if I were you.
So far, it's been a rough day. To make up for lost time, he decides to start fastening down the diamond plate. Out back, Travis and Danny weld their homemade hinge to the tabletop. It's time to put their table to the test.
Let's make sure it works first.
Yeah, it really.
On the way, they find Lester drilling holes in Travis's precious diamond plate.
No.
Just wait on the diamond plate for me, okay?
Oh, dude, no way.
We don't got the weather stripping underneath it, Dan. We asked everybody to not touch the diamond plate. Please.
Where's your screws at?
They've all gotta be countersinked and stuff. Uh-huh. If you want it to look right, it's gotta be done right. That is like,
I'm buttoning it up.
Don't. Just leave all the diamond plate stuff alone.
Okay.
Not weather stripping the diamond plate and not countersinking the screws buys Lester a one-way ticket into the monster doghouse. Lester takes the only fans he's gained today out back to give them a facelift.
Basically grind it down so it goes from this to that.
That looks much better. A lot better.
In the dining room, the crew wrestles the hood onto their handcrafted hinge.
Back. Keep that right there.
Nice ride. All right.
There you go.
Check it out.
Now this is drive-in dining.
It's gonna look sweet, guys.
Good. And you know the best part about that Honda hood? That will last forever.
Danny and Travis head back to the kitchen to rescue their diamond plate countertop.
We don't know where the cup key is.
In spite of the friction, it's been a productive day. The bar stools, the Honda hood, and the diamond plate countertop can be crossed off the to-do list. The only crew member who's not celebrating is Lester, who is still out back trying to make a pair of $10,000 fans look like radiators. But don't forget, there's still enough work to last a normal construction crew 2 weeks. These guys have only got 2 days. Thursday morning, Lester's looking like a new man.
Today's gonna be another good day, like every day. Thursday.
One more day after today. So what we're gonna do now is make a list of the things that we need to get done.
4 rooms to remodel, and not one anywhere near completion.
I just wanna say good luck. Have a great day.
Feeling the crunch, Steve jumps in to help Mike and Kurt hang a mounting plate for the vent hood.
Steve, can you? Here.
Mark here.
There you go.
That's what I'm talking about.
Take some time to roll me off the stool.
Getting closer.
Lester attaches half-inch steel rods to support the range hood. Up above, in fiberglass heaven, Mike bolts the rods to the ceiling joists.
This metal plate, as this metal plate's holding up a whole lot of weight.
Get this thing up, get the headers on, start putting on the pulleys. Knock this out. Let me have it. Good, let me check the other way.
Yeah.
Hold on. Bam!
Well, there it is.
Right there.
In the dining room, the dynamic duo, Travis and Danny, mount an electric winch to raise and lower the table.
That's the winch that's gonna operate the hood to come up and down. Hanging from the ceiling up there. Up, down.
There you go.
Okay, where we got center, center's right here. So we want the cable right on center.
They reattach the table and then connect up the cables.
Yeah.
It's a motorized Murphy table.
On the wine.
All it needs now is a plexiglass tabletop.
No, I mean it's because it's not going in all the way.
But first, the team goes from Murphy's table to Murphy's Law. The boys on the hood just made a major mistake.
It's your design.
No, you're right.
Yep. Okay, hold on. Who measured it? You measured that, right? We put it up?
Yeah.
We just got set back about 4 or 5 hours, I believe, because it got measured wrong.
My bad.
They mounted the hood too far to one side, so now it's not over the cooktop. I guess an honest mistake, but a costly mistake.
The whole thing's got to be torn down and moved over. Outside, Kurt does a little extra venting. Two precious hours have been tossed away, but the hood is finally hanging.
That ball's level.
Lester lops off the excess rod. Then he and Steve drill holes for the dual exhaust.
That's pretty.
Out back, Lester cuts the ducts.
There's one. There we go, we're locked in. We're good.
And finally, what every racing kitchen needs, engine headers. Outside, the airbags are being attached to the bed.
This is a monstrosity of a shock tower. Basically, we're gonna build 4 of these, drill hole, put the airbag up in there, go down to the wheels so we can basically get the bed lower to the ground.
But there's no way to fit this tricked out California King through the bedroom door. So final assembly will have to be done inside.
The pressure is on.
This is controlled chaos.
In the living room, Lester is mounting his chopped down fans to the ceiling.
Okay, I'm moving right here. Okay. Yeah. There you go.
Tight, okay.
They strap on the drive belts. A few final rivets, and they've got a gearhead's vision of heaven.
Ceiling's off. We put a level on them. They were 3/8 off. Yeah, baby.
Woo! The feel of this is just completely taken.
Yeah. That's bitching. That is awesome.
I think we need to make dinner for the crew tonight.
The crew's getting hungry, so Steve raids the fridge.
Hello?
Yeah, is this Kara?
Yes.
Hey, it's Steve from the house.
Hi.
Would you look out the window for a second?
Would I what?
Will you look out the window for a second, please?
Will I look out the window for a second?
Yeah, come on. I just want to ask you a couple questions.
Okay. Let's see.
The guys are getting a little hungry, and I was wondering, I found some boneless chicken breasts in the freezer.
You found some what?
Boneless chicken breasts in the freezer.
Uh-huh.
And some vegetables in the fridge and a couple of beers. I was wondering if you would mind if we have a snack.
Oh, go right ahead.
All right, cool. That's all I wanted to know.
Yeah, no problem.
All right, how you doing over there? You all right?
Yeah, I'm good. How are you doing in there?
I'm fine. You want some chicken and a beer? I'll send one over.
Yeah, the beer would be good. I don't know about the chicken, but send the beer.
All right, cool. Thanks.
All right, no problem.
All right,
bye.
Later.
Silly guys. Oh, they're in our fridge.
We're gonna have chicken and beer tonight.
But the prospect of Steve's home cooking sends the team racing off for takeout. The day of reckoning has arrived, but Steve is having his doubts.
We're close on a couple things, but I mean, that's a lot of stuff. Got 13 hours.
These look like they're for the
Travis and Danny kick off the morning by wiring up the bouncing bed.
Okay, wire boy.
I don't know what the hell goes on with this. Plug it in, that's about all I can do.
With the wheels in place, the street rod bed is ready for its first test drive.
Oh. Okay, step out of the way.
Yeah, it's not enough weight.
Finally, something else working, that's good.
A final touch, chrome exhaust pipes. In the kitchen, Lester installs the range hood's pull-down appliances.
Waterworks. Watch. Oh, are you okay? I'm sorry.
There.
And what would a monster kitchen be without a pneumatic egg beater?
Come on, Mom.
Finally, they weld on a camshaft so they can belt drive the vent fan.
Can you tack the top a little bit?
Thank God.
That's cool. It makes it bump like that.
Damn. Out back, Kurt is racing to rig up the hot rod lounge chair.
May just go up in flames when we touch the wire.
I don't know what's gonna happen.
He hooks up the battery and steps on the joystick.
That's not good.
Straight off the starting line, he blows a transistor.
Might have blown a transistor in here. That would mean that only one motor would run.
I have a backup plan.
It's back to the pits.
But I'm gonna tape this up, because I think this is what caused it to blow. It touched the frame, and it caused it to short out. Shorting out is always bad.
A few strips of tape later, he's back on track.
Success. Success.
Everything's coming together. One piece at a time. We've got our kitchen about to be up. This thing is gonna be up and running. The bed is just two steps away. The dining room table hood has just got needs a little cleanup. The kids' playroom is on its way. I think we're gonna get this thing done.
The boys in the bedroom connect up the gauges and bolt down the headboard.
Stereo boy can come in and wire all the wiring. We'll put the mattress on, clean this mess up. We're done.
Still a couple things to do. We're getting there, though. All right. Hour, 45 minutes.
At quarter to midnight, the only project still not finished is the motorized racing chair.
Whoa! Guys, you got 30 seconds.
Oh! Yeah, that works.
We got it. Yeah.
Kurt, you know what?
Mark that
damn chair off.
Scratch that, take it off.
Yeah. Yeah.
Done.
Good job, guys.
It's like New Year's Eve here.
What's wrong?
Right here, guys.
Before the Lopez's return, our monster decorating crew races in for some finishing touches, including a widescreen plasma TV from Just-in-Time Communications and race deck flooring from Wayne Pendery Construction. Coming up, the Lopez family crosses the finish line.
It's time to get the family. Welcome to your new house.
Oh my God!
Dude!
That is cool!
Oh, what?
Oh my God.
That is cool!
God! Oh my Lord, that's my car!
Dude!
Check it out!
Oh man! Oh man! Danny, what do we got here?
When it's dinner time?
No!
No! That is so cool.
Oh, that is dope.
That is awesome. That is absolutely awesome. This is so unexpected.
So cool.
Oh. All I can picture all day long is.
All right, come on over here.
Oh my God! What?
There's a camshaft running my fan. Headers, exhaust.
So you're gonna keep this stuff?
That's staying right there.
You got your Fanimation fans. Here's your switch right here. It gets all of them going.
That is.
Hey, let it crank up. It actually do work pretty good. Fanimation.
I know.
Here, have a seat in your new
bar stools.
They go up too.
Awesome.
No.
All right. Now, you want to cook, right? Take your pot, come on over here, put it on. What you want to do is, you want to fill it up. Okay. You want to make some eggs in the morning? Eggs. And we have your cooking oil on there. You go ahead and you want to clean it all off. You want to sweep the floor? Come on, sweep the floor. You want to check it out?
No.
You got Craftsman toolboxes for drawers. See that? Any large storage here? Get some monster steaks on this baby.
Oh my god.
That is dope. So, what do you think about your new kitchen?
That is awesome.
I love it.
That is the coolest thing I've ever seen. That is the coolest thing.
We were hoping you'd like it. Where is this?
All right, it's time to go into the playroom.
Playroom?
This is my favorite room in the whole house.
Oh my god.
Oh. No. Oh my god. Oh, Dan, that's me.
42-inch plasma screen television
for his playroom.
Mike, what you got? What's going on in here?
Oh, we got some 12-volt leading on the bottom here. We have controls on the sides. Both of the wheel wells are the place to store the toys. See? And then,
you can play PlayStation in here now?
Yeah. You like it? Yeah.
Monster Playroom.
You guys are seriously blowing me away.
Yeah, blowing me away.
Blowing me away.
Still not finished.
Now it's time to go into your master bedroom.
Oh,
oh my goodness, look at that.
That is just sweet.
This is you guys' high-speed bed right here. Complete with front headlights. Get on in bed.
Oh,
everybody get up there.
Get on up in there. Come on, kids.
Oh, he's never getting out of bed.
I'm never getting out of bed.
Never out of bed.
Yeah! That is awesome.
Shockwaves all the way around, fully adjustable.
I told you you could trust me. I told you could trust me.
Oh, gosh. I'm never going to get him nor the kids out of the bed.
Yeah!
I thought it couldn't get any better than the kitchen. No, it got better. And then better.
And we're still not finished.
What do you mean we're not finished?
We're still not finished.
Really?
There's still more to go.
No!
Awesome. Absolutely okay. Awesome.
From just-in-time communications electronics, we have a 5.1 surround sound system for you right here. Now we have one more thing we have to show you.
Come on!
One more thing.
It's hard.
Kurt, what do we have here?
Not only is this a comfortable chair,
no.
You can take this thing out.
Oh my god!
Drag racing on the weekend. It'll pull wheelies down the street.
Oh my lord.
No!
Be careful, I mean, you'll go through.
Yeah, let's not shoot through the
easily go through. So let's keep that off for now.
When they say monster,
you guys meant monster house.
It is the coolest thing.
That is dope.
You guys have seriously outdone yourselves.
Dude, I got a permagrin for like 2 weeks, at least.
It is awesome.
This thing
is
dope.
Absolutely awesome. Would not change a thing. Not a single thing.
We win!
Yeah!
Good job, guys.
All right, so good.
Bye, guys. Thank you for everything.
Congratulations, guys. You worked hard this week. Here are your prizes. You deserve them. You got a Makita 18-volt cordless combo kit, Makita 10-inch dual slide compound miter saw, and the GT350 Deluxe cutting and welding outfit from ESAB. Guys, that's all yours. Congratulations. That makes it all worth it.
Until next time, when who knows, the monster may be coming to your house.
I give up slowpoke, get out of my lane. I'm coming up faster than a speeding train. I'm a flash of lightning, a supernova. I'm telling you now, punk, you better pull over. Look at you driving that bucket of rust. I hope you're hungry, cause you're gonna eat my dust. Wow.